Come on.
The controls for this hatch are unresponsive. I'll need at least 5 pieces to be able to build a conduit long enough to run the generator to the unique. A small lump of electrically conductive putty. A good length of heavy-duty cable designed for carrying data. A reliable electric lantern that I cobbled together years ago.
Oh, okay. In the beginning, all was still and silent. Then, man, the All Builder, spoke the word, and the world begat the code. And so the world began to spin. Thus dawned the Primordium, the first age, the age of building. There were skyscrapers and airplanes there, yeah. Man moved across the world and built many wonders. In the heavens, he paved the sky roads. On the land, he raised mystic towers. And in the dark depths, he dug colossal caves. Most incredible of all were the many machines designed by man. But still, the All Builder was not satisfied. So, with both his hands, man built a body of steel in his own image. And with his right hand he gave logic, and memory he gave with his left. Then man said, "Now I will quicken this machine with the spark of power, and together we shall walk upon the earth." And it was done. Thus spun the world, and grew the code, and multiplied the living machines, and slowly passed the Primordium. Who can count the versions and generations that mark that age? In time, the All Builder looked upon the many things he had built, the sky roads and mighty towers, and above all upon the living machines. Weary with his labor, man sat himself beside the robots and said unto them, "For you, my children, I spoke the word and fired the engine of the world. For you I wrote the code, and to you I gave logic and memory." Then man, the All Builder, stood and shook and took the machines in his hands and guided them to a great mountaintop. Together they looked upon the world in its beauty. "All this was made for you, and now unto you all this is given. Keep it, tend it, and make it flourish." And the All Builder fell silent and passed from the world, and so ended the Primordium. We are lesser machines, built by those built by man. As we are but humble images of the All Builder, so he is the perfection of our forms, a machine of unbreakable form, endless memory, and absolute logic. For this we revere him and speak the word, and keep the code, and tend the world he gave to us.
I've read enough.
All right.
The controls for this the control pad for the deck access ladder. This is no time for a nap.
I still don't see why I don't get a bed.
Because you have a flat bottom to rest on.
Boss, were you checking out my bottom?
Hell yeah. Thick ass.
Without power from the ship.
All right.
A large observational telescope.
Chair, I can't sit down. There's clouds in the meadow.
Strange clouds, huh, boss?
Same old moon.
It's not going to let me go that way. I wanted to see if I could go from the top down here, get the large lantern.
There's no way I can reach that. What was I thinking, leaving all my lanterns up there? Crispin Horatio built, version 1. He'll be version 2 once I put some arms on him. He is my best and only friend.
So, what exactly do we need to fix the generator?
Some conduit.
People that watch this will probably think, oh my god, Is this guy for real? Stuck on the first puzzle like this? And what can I say? Me so stupid.
A good length of heavy duty cable. It's a data cable, not a power cable. Futile. I'll need at least 5 pieces to be able to build a conduit long enough to run the generator to the unique. How would that even work?
I don't know. I'm just trying shit, man.
That's never going to work. I doubt that will have any effect.
Okay. We got there.
If that red light went off, I bet the train would start going.
Crispin, sometimes I think you're trying to get me to waste time.
Who, me? Boss, just think of all the brothers and sisters you could make for me from all that junk.
One of you is more than enough.
Mmm.
Looks like an old P2, or is it a P3? It's locked tight. Looks like some kind of lockbox.
All right.
Still red. I can't see anything to do with it. There's a piece of Gordium conduit way back there. I can't reach the conduit.
Hey, boss, what about trying to open that lockbox I found earlier today? Maybe someone buried treasure in it.
Crispin, can you go in there and get that piece of conduit?
I suppose.
Gimme.
That would have been a lot easier with hands, boss.
Shut up, Crispin. Okay.
It's just scrap. Endless junk.
Beep beep boop. Endless junk. Beep beep boop boop.
Endless junk. I picked it clean years ago.
Well,
looks like an old P2. Or endless junk. It's just scrap. It's just scrap. There's nothing more of value in there.
All right.
Still locked.
Okay.
It's closed. It's locked tight.
Damn it.
You know, boss, I spend hours looking through junk. Maybe you could spend a little more time in the junk pile yourself?
It's just scrap. Endless junk.
How do you think a train...
Maybe they brought it here by boat.
Very funny.
Very funny.
Better just to leave it alone.
My exit? Guess not.
It's just scrap.
Maybe if I get you...
I'm not doing that until you build me some arms.
How do I build this motherfucker arms?
I don't really want to try that. Yep. that's the one I found. Yep, that's the one I...
Still locked. Let's see if this works.
Yeah, baby.
Is that a spark plug?
Yoink.
Box? Who locks up a spark plug?
Actually, I think that box was some kind of machine.
You killed it!
Recycled it.
That's right.
It's three pieces of Gordium conduit. Unfortunately, one of them is completely corroded and worthless.
Doesn't matter. We've still got five. Can we use...
It's a reinforced steel.
Oh, I'll go on, though.
There's no reason to cut that, or burn it, or... There's no reason to cut... I would waste the torch's whole charge before...
Fair enough. Okay, so we've got the spark plug and we've got the conduit. So... Yes.
Just a run-of-the-mill spark. It won't work until they're locked together. Five segments of Gordium conduit. Not a bad idea, but it can't carry enough of a charge, and it isn't sticky enough to hold them in place. Time for a little welding.
Here we go, we're making progress.
That was easier than I thought it would be.
I'm a knot cutter.
A good length of fused conduit. I'll need to get a closer look to see how it fits together.
Alright. Does that need to be connected up to anything? I don't think so. Ayo!
Stole our core, but just like that, problem solved.
The problem is not solved.
Well, I agree. The noise leaves something to be desired.
This is an emergency generator, Crispin.
Well, it was an emergency, boss.
It only runs for a few days, if that.
Oh.
That's not good.
Well, do we have another one?
No, which means it still is an emergency.
Well, in that case, first dibs on the recharge station.
Right.
So, what's the plan, boss?
We need to recover our power core.
Or we could just take the train to Metropole and live in luxury!
First of all, there is no train to Metropole. And second, even with full charges, we can't just walk there. But more importantly, I hate that city.
Mm.
It's in my core logic. I don't know why, but I can't change it.
Okay. In that case, can you just make us a new power core?
Yes, but I need some kind of strong energy source for that.
And you just make one of those too? I'm just asking.
No, but somewhere around here are the plans for an energy sensor.
That's awfully convenient.
I designed it a long time ago, before I made you. I even found a sodium iodide crystal to use in the sensor, though man alone knows where it's buried now.
Another achievement unlocked. Charged up.
We're fine on energy, for now. It's the Unique's recharging station.
Hey boss, what do all these buttons and switches do?
E.
I think there's some sort of defense mechanisms, but I can't figure them out.
Mm-hmm.
I've never been able to figure it out. I don't need any of these right now.
Let's hope it stays that way.
A collection of product manuals, how-to guides, and technical treatises.
Do you think the sensor design might be in here?
No, these are all books I scavenged. Crispin, why is your diary still scattered all over the floor?
Are you going to keep nagging me until we run out of power, boss?
Yes. It's Crispin's log. In order to preserve his privacy and my sanity, I've avoided reading it.
Fair enough.
In the dunes, it reads, pound pastrami, canned kraut, six bagels, bring home for Emma. I found this in the dunes. It's Crispin's to-do list. Funny how it never gets any shorter.
That's your fault, boss, not mine.
City of glass and light.
It's Crispin's to-do
list. Energy is shared with all robots. Here is haven for all.
There's the design. I'll put the keynotes into my data pouch.
How does it even work?
The crystal pulses when it absorbs energy. The cable carries the pulse to the computer. The computer decodes the information and displays it on the monitor.
Boss, where are we going to find a working computer?
The Unique is full of them.
Oh, right.
The energy sensor requires a sodium iodide crystal connected to a cable.
Oh, which in turn a JO crystal. CPU and a monitor. You jack up with the bros. Nice.
The energy sensor requires a sodium iodide crystal.
Come, join us in Metropole. Geocoordinate 894.
Something here.
All are equal in Metropole.
The original designs for Crispin.
Hey, there are arms here. An awesome set of tractor treads.
I went with a maglev unit instead, and I never could find good arms.
Weary wanders. Come,
the original design.
Join us in Metropole. City of glass and light. Our energy is shared with all robots. Here is Haven.
A Quantum Questron LCD monitor.
Come, hell yeah.
Join us in Metropole. Geocoordinate
894. That record player was a good find, Crispin.
I still think you should have let me have its arm.
I'm pretty sure that arm
join
came from a sewing machine.
Together, let us begin.
On second thought, maybe I should have let you have it.
Weary wanderers, come. Join us in Metropole. City of glass and light. Our energy is shared with all robots. Here is haven for all and strength in numbers. Come,
is it okay if I sleep
in
the cradle until we have a new power core?
No.
All are equal in Metropole. Weary wanderers, come. Join us in Metropole. City of
I bet I can find a better use for this plug.
Our energy.
But now we can't listen to the sweet voice of Metropole.
I guess that makes two birds. Nothing more to do with it.
Thought I heard a song.
That is where our power core should be shedding its light silently.
There's nothing I can do with it until I... The only way I can use this is by plugging something in.
Yeah, I've got the thing, so I'll be plugging that in.
It's a universal interface plug.
Okay.
It fits, but there's no point unless I connect the plug to something else first.
My butthole? Hopefully that phonogram has like, yeah. Now we get the game atmospheric music back again. Good. Good, good. Okay. So, plug. Oh, hull bridge.
I don't think that would be wise. Yet another reason that besotting robots should be reduced to scrap.
Besot, that seems to be the prevailing swear word.
old rag.
Damn it.
Wow, first the power core and now a rag. This is not your day. Now, I'm not a fancy engineer like you, boss, but it seems like the Unique isn't gonna fly without its tail on.
Interesting ship, isn't it?
Some rotted alloy support beams. I can't pick that up. Twisted corroded copper with micro sandwich ceramics. Mm-hmm. Too bad this stuff is mostly unworkable with a plasma torch.
Salute the flag of Horatio's clumsiness.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if the flag went down below. And we can probably use that to the grease leak. Speculation.
The generator's up and running. It's the Unique's tent. Some very sticky grease. I can't just scoop it up.
We can maybe use the telescope.
This isn't the time to test out the telescope.
How do I turn it off?
This isn't the time to test out the telescope.
All right.